Hello everyone, happy day wherever you are. I'm wishing you a beautiful and amazing moment wherever you are in the world and whenever you listen to this. Today we have our tarot card reading for July 4th to July 5th. Thanks for joining me. And I have our three card spread shuffled over the cards. I prayed over them. And we have with us a dynamic energy that is asking us to come into greater alignment with what your objectives are and what you're working on at this point in your life. And so today we have the Four of Wands, we have the Seven of Wands, and finally the Two of Wands. So clearly, this is a full wand spread, and the wands themselves indicate fire energy. It indicates action, passion, activity, creativity, creation, taking action, moving ahead. It's the energy that creates and builds things, develops things in physical form. It's sort of that warrior spirit, kind of going out into the world and manifesting things, taking life in your hands or taking the reins in your hands and taking control of the situation. So we have that kind of energy happening right now for today and till tomorrow. And so what this means for you, and as you work on yourself, on your life, what's happening in your life right now, so allow yourself to feel where this makes the greatest sense, because where we have the Four of Wands, it's a nice stability. So it represents harmony, celebration, acknowledgement of your blessings and how good life can be and how good life is already. And this is wonderful. Here in the US, we're celebrating Independence Day, 4th of July. So there is that spirit and energy of celebration. And it's in the name of victory and in the name of proclaiming where you stand and who you are and your identity and place in the world. So that is the main message, is sort of taking stock of who you really are and celebrating your identity, celebrating your individual contribution to the world, and also celebrating how far you've come on this path called life, this journey, this cosmic wheel that goes round and round, and we proceed with faith and hope. And so the Four of Wands is inviting us to embrace that notion and that spirit of celebration, of celebrating yourself, celebrating with those around you, the harvest and the bounty that you possess. That is really key, and that is the prevailing tendency right now. And if you're not in that space just yet, then invite yourself to move towards the light and to look towards the blessings and to just rest in that space. Now, this is a really nice, cozy energy, sort of like being at home. And yet, we have then the Seven of Wands, which is a really fascinating card, which represents, my feeling from it today is competing interests and having too many thoughts in your mind and having too many factors to consider, maybe too many people wanting to take hold of your attention, different things that you feel a duty or responsibility about doing or acknowledging. And so there may be a tendency to feel overwhelmed by, first you're in this space of celebration, but then you have this thought comes into your mind that, hey, wait a minute, there's other things I need to do, other responsibilities I should take care of. It's not right, or it doesn't make sense to only be feeling good. So this card is more about you overcoming those tendencies and those stressful thoughts and moving in a direction of more empowerment and standing in your power and to move beyond the space and mental state of being blocked by too many like factors that you need to overcome or obstacles and challenges. I get the sense that for some of us, there is like the societal pressure that you're supposed to prove yourself or you're supposed to prove your worth and that you're supposed to battle and struggle for whatever it is that you want. And I am inviting us to turn that belief upside down and to question whether you accept it for yourself, whether you accept that belief as true for you, because it may be true for another, but it doesn't have to be your personal truth. You don't have to embrace that. Rather, proceed with your life, with what you're intending now, your decision. Move ahead with your own conviction and your own sense of self and for your own reasons, and do it in your own way. Like Frank Sinatra's song, he did it his way, I did it my way. So take over your world, conquer your universe, and be the captain of your ship, but decide based on what works for you, what feels right for you, okay? Because if you do that, then you will move ahead from a greater sense of stability. And of course, also drawing on inspiration and motivation from the outside. However, the bulk of your strength will come from within, because you're going to remain with yourself for the rest of your life, and you're going to weather the storms with yourself. All right, so that is really key, is to overcome those limiting beliefs and patterns of thoughts that suggest that life has to be a struggle, because it doesn't have to be. It's only a belief, and you may have experienced that in your life till now in some phases, because that's what you accepted as the norm, or that's what you saw from your family, your friends, from TV, from bosses or managers or colleagues or friends, that this is the way it has to be. But as you grow older and wiser and you expose yourself to more material that uplifts and empowers you, you will soon learn that it's not like that. And actually, each person is in control of their destiny by using and managing and mastering the thoughts they think, mastering their body, mastering their energy, mastering their words, okay? So you are the master, and this is a reminder that you are the master and that you are the captain of your ship. So seize your power now and choose your words, choose your actions, and be deliberate about your focus, okay? So then we have, the next card is the Two of Wands. So from that struggle that we overcome, it goes into this Two of Wands, which is a fellow that is contemplating the land and the opportunities of the universe, which is represented by this globe here. So I feel that after we've overcome those limiting beliefs and subverted them and told them to like, hey, those are old limiting beliefs. It may be true for some, it's not true for me. This is what I believe. It used to be true, but not anymore. So now it means that you have a lot more options at your disposal, and the world is your oyster always. And this is what that fellow symbolizes, as he has the world in his hands. He's deciding, where should he go? What should he do? Where should he discover? What is his next journey? So what is your next journey? What are your next steps? Where are you contemplating traveling to? Or what projects and initiatives do you want to initiate or cultivate or continue developing, right? What are your options right now? Because the world is your oyster as you remove those blocks and those cobwebs. So as it brings us back to this number two energy, which is a very incipient energy, it's a very preliminary card. Number two is the beginning of the range from 1 to 10. So what does this mean, right? Why are we going back? We went from 4 to 7, then back to 2. And I meditated and I asked spirit and the universe, I asked God to give us further clarity about how can I move forward, right? How can we move ahead without going back again and again? And not that it's bad to go back to the beginning, because life is a cycle, it's a wheel. So again, you'll get through this phase and then go into a next phase, and then you'll want to get through that one and start again as a baby. So I meditate on it, and then shuffling, praying, we received a third card, which was quite powerful, which is the star. And the star came out reversed. So, the star is a major arcana which represents universal cosmic forces at play, and it represents major life destiny reasons and motivations and explanation for why things are the way they are. And this card, the main message is to trust your intuition, to follow your heart. It's really important now to realize that you have overcome the struggle, which was the preceding card of the tower. That is done, okay? You don't need to suffer again the way you did. If you do, that will be your choice, but you don't have to go that way again. Okay, you do not have to go that way again. Now you're in the star, which is an energy of being pure, being cleansed, starting a new phase, being divinely and profoundly blessed by the universe. So if you find yourself, friend, in a position where you feel like, gosh, I am so lucky, I am so blessed, and is it really like true? Then, yes, this is a reminder that yes, it is. This is reassurance and an affirmation that you are indeed in your place, in your path, that this is the right unfolding. Now is the time to heed and trust your intuition even more, to trust the universe, trust God, trust and have hope and faith that things will work out one step at a time. But this means that you're going into new territory and you're going into a new phase of life, okay? And it is involving more of your intuition and more of your inner guidance, and not going back to those storms and uncertainty, but not even uncertainty, but more of the what you've already experienced to be suffering. You've been through that, and it doesn't have to happen again. Okay, so that is it. It is about trusting the universe, trusting your intuition, and knowing that when you check in with your heart, you really do know what to do. All right, so be authentic, be yourself. I have my notes here. Rely on your intuition and trust and have faith, okay, in your true self. So that's it for today. Thanks for joining. And if you want to book your private reading, send me a message on the Facebook Tarot coaching page and we'll get you set up immediately. Have a blessed day and see you tomorrow. Take care. Bye.